like you've been saying, you only get married to the same guy twice.
Once, baby, let's go.
Ooh, baby, married again.
Good luck marrying that guy twice.
Everyone, as you may know, today is 5-9-2020. Although official, it's just a preview of a more formal ceremony, and more importantly, a party to be held, ironically, on 9-5-2021.
How are you feeling today?
Feeling good. Yeah, it's a deja vu all over again.
This is the third time that I've done a best man speech, with the second being his first wedding.
The good news is we added to her Instagram account by having two weddings instead of one.
We're here with the mother of the bride. How are you?
Hi, I'm great, thanks.
What are we doing here right now?
I'm fixing Meredith's underwear.
Okay, there you go.
All right, you've waited 2 years to see this. Hi. I love you. Thank you. You look really good. Can you see the back?
Slow spin.
You like it?
You look great.
Thanks, you look really good too. I love you.
I always knew that someday, some boy would ask me for her hand. And I'd say yes,
hi.
Unless I knew that he was the half that makes her whole. I think we know how that turned out. I want you to never forget that I love you. If I could give you one thing, it'd be the ability to see yourself through my eyes. And that way you'd know how special you are.
Nothing like I've ever experienced. It's nothing like I've ever seen.
Well, it's finally here, guys. Spencer, on May the 9th, 2020, in the middle of all that mayhem, you took Meredith Zimmerman to be your wife. Meredith. On that same day, you committed yourself to become Spencer's wife. Today, your family and friends have gathered to celebrate that happy event with you.
Even though the pandemic has ruined a lot of things, one thing that we're sure that it did was strengthen you guys as a couple. It shed light on what's most important in life and taught us that even when life isn't easy, we have lots to be thankful for. Marriage is one of those things. Love isn't easy, it gets hard and messy, but it's a beautiful mess.
You weren't deterred by all of that happened last year. You let your love bring you together, and you have been a wonderful couple from that day to this.
It's nothing like I've ever experienced.
Good luck again.
I want to share a reading with you. In searching, I came across one that reminded me a lot of how I see you and your relationship. It's an excerpt from A Bridge Across Forever, which is very fitting since we're in Madison County. A soulmate is someone who has locks that fit our keys and keys to fit our locks. When we feel safe enough to open the lock, our truest selves step out and we can be completely and honestly who we are. We can be loved for who we are and not for who we're pretending to be. Each unveils the best part of the other. No matter what else goes wrong around us, with that one person, we're safe in our own paradise. Our soulmate is the one who makes life come to life.
I've had the great opportunity and fortune to be on that ride with such a special and amazing partner. And I can't tell you how easy she's made this year and a half for me, but obviously for us together.
We're honored to have Spencer as our son-in-law and all the hammocks now as part of our extended family.
And I love you so much, and I truly could not imagine anyone more perfect for her to move away and take care of each other's dreams. I just love you both so much. Okay. Here we go again. We've been here before.
Me too.
But it wasn't as long as I hoped.
Meredith, I love you.
Meredith, I love you.
Spencer, I love you.
Spencer, I love you.
You accepted this ring.
You accepted this ring.
As the visible token.
As the visible token.
Of the covenant.
Of the covenant.
I have with God.
I have with God.
And with you.
And with you.
It represents my love.
It represents my love.
My commitment.
My commitment.
My vow to be faithful to you.
My vow to be faithful to you.
My vow to be faithful to you.
For as much then as Spencer and Meredith have consented together in holy wedlock and have declared the same before God, and in the presence of these witnesses, I reaffirm that they are husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, what God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Spencer, you may kiss your bride. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Spencer Hammock.
Only half past 12, but I don't care.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Just do it!